This video gives a brief overview to control charts in the SPC for Excel package. There are 27 control charts in the SPC for Excel package, 5 attribute control charts, 22 variable control charts, and a number of actions you can do on completed control charts. This video is going to look at 6 things. It's going to look at how you create a control chart. We're just going to make a basic X control chart. How you add a comment to a point that might be out of control, for example. How you delete a point from the calculations. How you split the control limits. How you lock the control limits, and how you add new data to the control chart. To create any control chart using the SPC for Excel software, you start by entering data into an Excel spreadsheet. We've done that. We have some quality characteristic that we're sampling over time, and we have our results for that quality characteristics here in column B, and our sample number in column A. The data doesn't have to be in column, it can be in rows. And to start, though, we want to select our data. Makes things a little easier for us down the road, so we go to Utilities, hit Select Data, and then we go Select Variable from the Control Chart portion of the SPC for Excel ribbon. And we have our subgroups, charts, our individual charts, between within charts, time-weighted charts, and multivariate charts, 22 total variable control charts. We're going to use an X chart, so we go and select X chart from the individuals chart, we select OK. And we get our input form for the X control chart. And what you'll see is the sample identifiers is assumed to be the first column that we've selected. The data is in the second column we've selected. All we need to do is to enter a name into the name of the chart text box, and we're just going to call it example. And this is all you need to do to make an X control chart. There are some options we'll talk about in a few minutes. You select OK, and you generate your X control chart. So let's take a look at the completed control chart and just what it looks like. Here you have the upper control limit, you have your average, and you have a lower control limit. You have a couple other lines which are used for the zone test for out of control points. You have the option not to plot those. Then you have your data plotted over time. And some of the points are in red. And if you have red points, that means you have some out of control points in your process. Now suppose we know the reason for the out of control point for this point, and what we'd like to do is to add a comment to that to explain it. It's easy to do. What you simply do is you select the point where you want to add the comment, you go to the SPC for Excel ribbon, and you select actions. And this is the control chart actions that you can take on a chart that's completed, that you've already built. For example, you can split control limits at this point, you can remove from or add back the point to the calculations, you can add or replace commas to this point. And that's what we want to do. We're going to add a point, we know the reason, and so we're going to call it maybe a new operator. And select OK, and then you'll have the comment added to the point. And this comment stays with that point as you add new data to the chart. Now, since we know the reason for the out of control point, perhaps we want to remove it from the calculations. We can do that also. So what you do is you select the point, you go back to Actions, and you select Remove or Add Back this point to calculations. We're going to remove it. Note that the average down here is 11.2. So we go ahead and we're going to remove that point, select OK, and what happens is you have the points been removed from the calculations. You've got a new average of 10.3, and you can see it's no longer in red up here. So that's how you remove a point from the calculations. You can repeat the process to add it back to the calculations if you would like. Now if you take a look at this chart, you can see it kind of looks like maybe there are two processes, one that operates up here someplace, and then somewhere around sample 11 it appears that there's been a decrease, and maybe there's something we did to improve the process and you'd like to split the limits. So again, it's easy to do. What you're going to do simply is select the point where you want to split the limits. Sometimes Excel does that to you. You come back and select the point, and then you go to the SPC for Excel ribbon again, select actions, and here we're going to say split control limits at this point. You select OK. And you can see now that we have split control limits. The average was around 12.6 back here, and our new average is around 8.3. Now suppose that we want to lock these control limits so they don't change as we add new data into the future. We'll show you how to do that and how you add new data. To set these limits so they don't change, it's very easy. You just simply go to our Options button on the SPC for Excel toolbar menu and select Example, which is the name of the chart that we want to change the options on. Select OK, and all you have to do is come in here, Automatic Updating Limits, select that to No, and these limits will now stay the same. So that means when we go back to add new data, which is very easy to do to a chart, you come down now and you want to add new data. Maybe you have a data point 21, and we're going to say that that data point is like 17. Okay. And you've added your new data, and you want to update the chart now with the new data. You select Update, select the chart you want to update. You have the option also to update all charts that are listed. Select OK, and you have your new data point added, and it happens to be out of control. But know that the average and the upper and lower control limit did not change. They stayed the same. So this quick overview to control charts in the SPC for Excel package showed you how to create a control chart, how to add a comment to a point, delete a point from the calculations, split the control limits, lock the control limits, and add new data to the control chart. Thank you for taking time to watch the video. Have a great day.